Hello, everyone, and welcome to The Vortex, where lies and falsehoods are trapped and exposed. I'm Michael Voris, coming to you from Baltimore, where the bishops are gathering this week to accomplish absolutely nothing. Nothing except make things appear as though it's just business as usual, which, in some ways, if you consider that what the bishops have done over the past decades has been to engage in either immoral activity, unethical activity, sinful activity, then yeah, it kind of is just business as usual. But the difference with this year's conference is that right along beside us over here, this is the Miku Pavilion, the much ballyhooed, we had to go to court and win this case in the 4th U.S. Circuit Court in order to come here and have this rally. There's going to be a huge crowd of Catholics in there, right across the little waterway here where the hotel is, where the bishops are going to be meeting. Programming note for all of you, if you're unable to attend here in person, but you still want to watch the rally, Church Militant will be live stream coveraging this on our website tomorrow at 10:30 in the morning, with the rally itself beginning at 11. Now, as we take this useless conference, annual conference, apart piece by piece tomorrow with a host of very well-informed speakers who know just how deep the corruption runs, one thing stands out to us in the planning stages of all of this, and that is the complete lack of interest in the so-called Catholic media covering this rally. We have credential requests from a bevy of secular media outfits, the AP, the Washington Post, the New York Times, local Fox, and so forth. But oddly enough, not one Catholic establishment media outlet, not one so-called Catholic for that point as well. As we've been saying for months now, and certainly a lot in the last couple of weeks, we anticipate between 1,500 and 2,000 faithful Catholics here tomorrow, and they're going to be listening to survivors of sex abuse, canceled priests, Catholics in good standing, suing bishops for a host of issues and so forth. Yet somehow the bishop propagandists in the bought and paid for media don't think that's a worthy story to cover. So let's lay this out very clearly for you right now, shall we? The so-called Catholic media are liars. They deceive you every day by refusing to tell you the whole truth. We've pounded this drum now for over a decade, perhaps no event brings this home, the stark reality home, more than this rally. Even before the rally, Church Militant won that massive case in the U.S. Fourth Circuit Court of Appeals, which allowed this rally to even happen. Those headlines exploded across major secular outlets all over the country, AP, Reuters, Washington Post, and so forth. The case followed with intense interest, first by major First Amendment attorneys all over the country who were in touch with us. Amicus briefs were filed on our behalf, and a resounding free speech victory was won to ensure this rally happened. Even if the bishop propagandists don't like Church Militant, that is news. And you can bet your bottom dollar, had we lost, they would have been reporting that. But over in the EWTN, Catholic News Agency, National Catholic Register, Catholic News Service, Relevant Radio, Ave Maria Radio, St. Anthony Messenger, Our Sunday Visitor, and every other single establishment outfit that has anything to do with the church, complete silence, not a peep. A virtual landmark ruling handed down by the U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals just never happened to cross in front of their eyes. Funny enough, the only outfit remotely related to the church that did report on this was the heretical National Catholic Reporter, also known as the Distorter for its dissent and heterodoxy. So why would Catholic establishment media, and that includes the new kids on the block, The Pillar, which is a shadow operation run behind the scenes by Archbishop Charles Chaput, who has his own problems when it comes to combating evil in the hierarchy, why would all these outfits ignore a major story like this? Remember, this story has two major parts to it. There's the lawsuit leading up to the rally, and then, of course, the rally itself. There are multiple angles to cover in each part, yet nothing from the lying, deceptive Catholic media. Here's why. Because every single one of those corrupt organizations knows which side its bread is buttered on. For example, the only mention of the rally in the lawsuit we saw in the establishment gang was a couple of tweets from J.D. Flynn. Flynn is Chaput's puppet, a poor canonist who never excelled in his chosen field, was then plucked out of mediocrity by Chaput, who he worked for in Denver, and made head of Catholic News Agency after never having had one day of experience in journalism. That's the perfect type of guy the bishops love to use and promote, just like when they choose who to ordain. They look for weaklings with no backbone who will be company men. J.D. fits the bill perfectly. Who provided the only comment on the rally and lawsuit among professional Catholics, as Pope Benedict called them. He accused Church Militant of creating all this drama around the lawsuit as a means to raise money. You'd be hard-pressed to find a more moronic assessment. But then again, what else can you expect from a supposed journalist with no actual journalism background? We mentioned J.D. and his privately supported pillar because he is the only one who commented on the story, and then in an idiotic fashion. But J.D. and the pillar represent everything wrong with the Catholic media. They're just the latest ones on the block. As Archbishop Chaput's private money people fuel the pillar, a disturbing strategy appears. Disclose only what needs to be disclosed so as to protect the crimes and sins of the bishops as a body. That's why J.D. won't answer any questions about where the funding comes for his site, because, in fact, it's not his site. J.D.'s just a well-paid stooge. The pillar is a somewhat useful tool of Chaput's and his private money people who think revealing some of the truth is a winning strategy to preserve the church. Well, think again, Archbishop Chaput. And even though he's retired, he still knows stuff, and he just pumps that info to J.D., who then dutifully reports it how Chaput and his people want it reported out. How do they want it reported out exactly? Well, here's the way to begin to dovetail nicely with the rest of the bishop-controlled established media. Whatever gets reported is never reported in context. That is deliberately left out of all of the reporting of all of the Catholic media. It's one thing to say such and such priest was convicted or caught or exposed, but that is always just the tip of the iceberg, as they say. All the more meaningful questions are never asked, much less reported. How did that guy get into seminary? How did he pass through to ordination? How did he rise up the ranks? How did he go undetected for so long? What kind of formation did he receive? Who were his associates? Was anything ever reported about him to his local bishop? What did his bishop do in response to the reports? The reason none of those questions are ever asked, much less put into print, is because they go straight back in a direct line to the complicity of the bishops in all of this. Where are all the Catholic establishment media stories on James Grine, McCarrick's most notable victim, who came public on this very stage almost 3 years ago to the day and will be leading off the rally tomorrow? Where's all the reporting on dozens of pro-sodomy bishops in that meeting right up there on the second floor and the evil that they're inflicting on souls, not to mention bodies? All the Catholic establishment media, including relevant radio, who, by the way, if you remember, took money from the Biden campaign to run his ads for him until they got busted. All of them will be here reporting on the meeting. But the meeting is not the story. But then again, they know that. But they have to engage in all the drama of the meeting to make it seem like they're actual reporters. If you want a template to understand how they work in this kind of environment, then look no further than CNN's Anderson Cooper holding a town hall with Biden. A total setup. What the fake Catholic media news outlets will never do is bring up that third rail topic of homosexuality within the bishop's group. That would mean total and immediate ostracizing by the queens in the conference who run the show. And what's more, they know it, which of course is why they never report it. They don't even breathe it. How do these media types go to sleep at night knowing they are part of the entire complicit crowd? In fact, they're the major ones who are complicit because they are the gatekeepers who prevent you from knowing the truth. Some of them, like EWTN, may squawk on a little bit about Pope Francis and corruption in Rome. Good for them. But where the rubber hits the road, right here in the U.S., with gay bishops, gay-friendly bishops, bishops covering up abuse, protecting their clergy who have boyfriends, looking the other way on financial theft, paying enormous sums to attorneys to keep the cover-up rolling along, on all that, they're like dead men. They never breathe anything. Never is there a breath on their lips. There's a reason so many faithful are coming to Baltimore beyond the rally itself. They come to condemn the complicity of the entire establishment, most especially the corrupt Catholic fake news media, who own this downfall of the church almost as much as the homosexual-loving bishops themselves. For any of the few more ethical individuals within the ranks of that bishop propaganda machine, here's a little short message for you. If your conscience is troubled at your role in covering all of this up, all this victimization, and your consciences should be, well, please contact us quietly. We're looking for a few good Catholics, and we know there are only a few out there to help us report the whole and entire truth, as it should be. The bishops and the USCCB has done everything it can over the past dozen years to crush church militant because of what we report about them. But funny thing about the truth, it's its nature to be known. It always finds a way. The rally the bishops tried to kill in secret at the city of Baltimore here goes off tomorrow. We took your best shot, guys, you crooked hierarchy. Now it's time to hear from all the victims of your evil. It's time to hear their voices. Too bad the propagandist fake Catholic media will continue to ignore them, but church militant won't. We'll be right here for them. God love you. I'm Michael Voris.